take a moment to say the Pledge of Allegiance with me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The library will be closed for all lunch shifts this week and Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of next week due to classes in the library. Be sure to check back the following week to have lunch in the library. Need help with school, friend, or family issues? Do you just need someone to speak with? Your DCMS guidance counselor is here for you. Fill out the Google form found in your grade level Schoology group or by using the link you see on the screen. Once your request is made, your counselor will come and collect you from one of your classes and escort you to the counseling office. Once there, you'll sign in and, after being seen, return to class with a pass from your counselor. Be sure to reach out as often as you need to. Mr. Hobson, Mrs. Selby, Mr. Dukes, and Ms. Pertleaf are here to help you in any way that they can. Do you need help with your STEM or science classes? Join us on Wednesdays after school in room 18 for tutoring help. All students are eligible to attend. Just fill out the Google form to register or reach out to Ms. Laracuda for more assistance. Our character trait of the week is acceptance, the ability to accept the difference of perspective with another person. Acceptance widens your perspective and helps you see a situation differently. A graphic novel or comic book? Can't get enough of the manga and anime? Really enjoy all things fantastical and comic? Well, Miss Hill, with the help of Miss Nicholson, was able to secure 4 free tickets to this year's Comic Con, which runs from October 22nd to the 24th. Winners will earn free entry into the Comic Con to meet over 100 graphic design and comic book artists face to face, purchase their favorite comics and graphic novels, get them signed, and even have the chance to participate and view the many costume contests of the weekend. Check out the website for more information and to find the artists you are most interested in. To enter to win these tickets, simply visit the DCMS Eagles Nest Schoology group every Wednesday, starting this week, to complete the entry form. The 4 winners will be announced on the morning announcements October 21st. All winners must attend with a paying adult and abide by the COVID precautions established by the Baltimore Comic Con. Good luck! She is one of the major leading voices for Hispanic Americans, the youngest person elected to the House of Representatives, and is known by her initials AOC. She is Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Congratulations to the following DCMS Eagles for getting the Smarticus question correct: Michaela Williams, Melvin Anderson, Emily McClelland, Kathleen Vasquez-Berrios, Kavian Washington, Leah Watkins, Sean Murphy, Isaias Mitchell, Aris Johnson, Chloe Critch, Robert James Cook, Vaughn Kaywork, Melvin Vasquez Cabrera, Ernest Nayarco, Quadir Evans, Adriana Adanceros, Zaya Flowers, Gloria Bongo, Kylie Deaver, Kyla Chikwe, and Alicia Conway. Your Eagle Bucks have been added to the Eagle Buck Bank.
It is time for I Am Smarticus. When you find out the answer to the question that follows, message Ms. Hill, and if your answer is correct, your name will be added to the wall of Smarticuses.
2, 5, 8, 14, and... Can you figure out what the next number should be and why? Time to use your logical thinking again.
Think, think, think. Think, think, think. I've got to think, 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 think.
In his era, Roberto Clemente was one of the greatest players. He was unique. Clemente played in a way that none of those other great players of that era, Mays, Aaron, or Mantle, did.
Baseball legend Roberto Clemente paved the way for Latinos in the major leagues.
Clemente is best known as that rare ball player who actually grew as a human being as his talents were diminishing. And he became a great humanitarian whose motto was, if you have a chance to help others and fail to do so, you're wasting your time on this earth.
Roberto Clemente was born August 18, 1934, in Carolina, Puerto Rico. In his late teens, his ability caught the eye of Major League scouts.
Clemente signed with the Dodgers in 1954. They'd scouted him and thought he had enormous talent. But because of that potential, the Dodgers actually tried to hide him up in Montreal, and they would not play him.
In 1955, Roberto Clemente was signed by the Pittsburgh Pirates, where he made his big league debut and where he spent the rest of his career.
None of the sports writers in Pittsburgh knew any Spanish. They would quote Clemente in broken English, pidgin English. If he said, I got a hit, they'd say, I got heat, H-E-E-T. That's how they'd spell it in the newspaper. He was an incredibly proud man, and it infuriated him when they did that.
Roberto Clemente comes to bat.
Over the next 18 years, Roberto Clemente quietly became one of the top players in baseball, winning 12 Gold Glove Awards, 4 batting titles, and leading the Pirates to 2 World Series championships.
Roberto Clemente had a gun for a right arm. This guy played right field, and if you even thought about taking an extra base on a hit out to right field, you better think again, because he could gun you down at second base, third base, or at home.
Clemente was the National League MVP in 1966 and played in 15 All-Star games.
End the game and the series with victory for the Pirates.
In his last regular season game of 1972, Roberto Clemente became the 11th player of all time and the first Latino in history to reach 3,000 hits.
Roberto Clemente reaching 3,000 hits allowed him to reach a milestone that Babe Ruth hadn't reached, that Lou Gehrig hadn't reached, that Mickey Mantle hadn't reached. It showed that this was an all-time great player.
On December 31st, 1972, a plane carrying Roberto Clemente crashed off the coast of Puerto Rico. He was on his way to Nicaragua to deliver emergency relief supplies to victims of a devastating earthquake.
When Roberto was killed, it was just stunning. I remember my heart sinking that New Year's Eve. When such a great athlete is killed in his prime, I remember being crushed. I wasn't a Pittsburgh fan. I was just a sports fan. I think it was devastating.
Clemente, by the time he died, was the patron saint of Latin American baseball. When word of his death arose, hundreds and hundreds of people drove to Pinones Beach near San Juan, Puerto Rico, where the plane went down, thinking that Clemente might walk out of the water.
Only 3 months after his death, Roberto Clemente became the first Latino ever to be inducted into baseball's Hall of Fame.
It's hard to say that anyone was the equivalent of Jackie Robinson, but Clemente is the closest thing. He was not the first Latino ball player in the major leagues, but he was the first great one. And because of the way he played and the way he lived, he set in motion a huge migration of Latino ball players into the major leagues.
Roberto Clemente was posthumously awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 2002.
Roberto Clemente's legacy is not only being one of the all-time great players, but being one of the all-time great heroes. It's a wonderful legacy. I think he's one of those people that when you say Roberto Clemente, you smile. He was great in so many ways on and off the field.
Today, we are going to imagine that we are painting a rainbow in the sky. And your fingers are the paintbrushes. Start with your hands by your side and your palms facing forwards. Now, when you see the red band of the rainbow start to appear, keep your arms straight and trace it upwards with your paintbrushes. Great! Now the red band is painted. Slowly bring your arms back down by your sides. Now you need to match your breathing to your painting. So when you raise your hands up for the next color, take a big breath in, and you can breathe out when you bring your arms back down. Get ready for the orange to appear. Imagine we have dipped our paintbrushes into orange paint. So breathe in and lift the arms up, and slowly back down as you breathe out. Now we're going to paint the yellow band. Imagine we have dipped our paintbrushes into the yellow paint. Breathe in as we paint the yellow band and lift your arms up. Now breathe out as you drop your arms down. Now the green band. Breathe in as we paint the green band, arms up, and breathe out as you drop your arms down. Now the blue band. Breathe in as we paint the blue band, arms up, and breathe out as you bring your arms back down. Now the indigo band. Breathe in as we paint the indigo band, arms up, and breathe out as you bring your arms back down. And now for the final color, violet. Breathe in and lift your arms up, and breathe out as your arms come down. Well done.